The suspension of Dr. Batera Nabiarugaba has taken on a new aggressive tone as the under fire executive director of Mulago National Referral Hospital begins a court fight to maintain his job. Infighting and self-generated financial crisis have made the past months of Dr. Baterana's term turbulent. Despite the ongoing investigations, earlier this week, Baterana maintained that his 11 years of service at Mulago have seen the National Hospital achieve a number of milestones.
We did construction of housing units for the first time actually since independence, of 110 housing units for the staffs that are available. In addition, we are constructing another 150. We did the planning and construction of Women's Hospital of 453 bed capacity with 11 working operating theaters. And this was planned as a specialized maternal and neonatal unit of Mulago National Referral Hospital. Later on, it was made to be a hospital of its own. We congratulate the managers of that. We operationalized Kawempe, Chirudu, and Upper Mulago as independent hospitals during the time when we were still using the same budget of Mulago, and we did not cause any known medical crisis or health crisis in this country.
According to the State House Health Monitoring Unit, the ongoing probe into management of Mulago Hospital involves, among other things, the illegal allocation of the hospital land to private pharmacies like First Pharmacy and Eco Pharmacy. However, in his defense, Baterana claims that for close to a decade, the hospital land has been threatened by grabbers.
The MOUs and the tenancy agreements between the two pharmacies were poorly conceived, poorly executed in our view, and without due diligence and clearance from the relevant government departments. The accounting officer of a public institution, which is not autonomous, has got a certain level of operation beyond which he can't commit government. The pharmacies are currently operating illegally without National Drug Authority licenses, so they are illegally existing.
Upon arrest on the 1st of March by the Health Monitoring Unit, Dr. Batera Nabiarugaba was charged with embezzlement, fraudulent accounting, abuse of office, and causing financial loss to the government. Baterana, who doubles as the accounting officer of a hospital, was detained with the hospital's principal administrator, engineer, head of accounts, senior accountant, and an accounts assistant. In April 2021, the Health Monitoring Unit launched an investigation into Mulago Hospital's management of essential medicines and health supplies, human resources for health and finance, covering four financial years. The total unaccounted for or misappropriated funds during the period under investigations amounted to 28.8 billion shillings.
I want to emphasize that these findings are preliminary. We shall continue to unpack them. We shall continue to engage the relevant officers, senior officers in Mulago, to further understand the expenditures, the accounting or lack of it, and the management of human resources.
This was not the first time Dr. Baterana was put under scrutiny over the misappropriation of funds at the nation's referral hospital. In August 2014, MPs on the Parliamentary Public Accounts Committee quizzed Baterana for making advance payments of 228 million shillings to individual accounts. In June 2019, while appearing before the Public Accounts Committee chaired by Nathan Nandala Mafabi, Baterana was put on the spot to account for 245 million shillings, which was not traceable on the hospital's bank accounts. The 2016-2017 and 2017-2018 Auditor General's report show that Mulago Hospital collected 2.45 billion shillings in the financial year of 2017-2018, but only 2.31 billion shillings was remitted. The balance of 145 million shillings could not be traced.
If we deliver services as expected, then definitely the brand of Mulago will go up. So I want to call upon you, ED, that you take on the responsibility that has been placed on your shoulder, steer the team, build teams, and ensure that we deliver.
I was amazed one time to hear There used to be a statement saying, I don't know how it is said in English, but in my language it says, Mgwebyabusha na marago bikahwayo, which means that free things which are free, even Mulago no longer gives them. I don't know where that thing came from, because Mulago City is a national referral hospital. It gives free service to the public, and it should continue giving those free services.
Even after the change of guard from Baterana to Dr. Rosemary Byanyima, the kicking out of private pharmacies from the hospital premises, much ought to be done to restore the stained brand of the country's national referral hospital. Dr. Baterana remains interdicted until investigations into the allegations against him are complete. Although his lawyers have since challenged the interdiction in courts of law, the matter is yet to be determined.